how to create a new user and modify its privileges in Linux. If you use Linux with a graphical desktop environment, such as Ubuntu for example, you can add and remove users through its settings. But it is simplified, and I have to say, a limited way to do that. The right way is to use a command line, and it is the only way if you work with Linux server. In this video, you will learn how to create a new user, both simplified and extensive ways, how to define its system privileges, and how to enhance your system security by setting password and account expiration time. And of course, how to delete a user. Everything in this quick video. The simplest way to create a new user in Linux. Many Linux systems have a user-friendly command to add a new user. This command is add user. You type this command and the username of a new user. The command will prompt you to create a user password, provide a full name, and some additional information which can be skipped if you want. And that's it, a new user, LU in my case, is created. You can switch to the new user account with the command su- and the new username. Everything works fine, except this user doesn't have any administrative privileges. Running a sudo command to update the system, for example, results in a warning that this user is not in the sudo others file. To add this user to the sudo group, you need to go back to the root account and execute the command add user, the new username, and sudo. Now, if you go back to the account of a new user, the update command with sudo will work. This was the simplest way to create a new user in Linux. Add user is a more user-friendly type of the command user add. It is available in many Linux distros. In my case, I use Debian UpCloud VPS, and add user is available. You can also get such a private server for free and test everything you will see in this video. Just use the promo code LU25 during the registration and you will get $25 to your account. I showed how to set up such an UpCloud server in my previous video. The link is in the description. If you are interested in having a private server, please go and watch it. More extensive and universal way to create a new user in Linux. If the add user command is not available, or you want to have little more control over the user, you need to use user add. I know, the names are similar and easy to mix, but try to remember that user add is a more important command. Basically, add user just points to user add. So you run user add and the new username, it will create a new user with the default options. To check the default options, run user add with the option D. These are the default rules of my Debian UpCloud VPS. They may differ for your system. However, you can change these options and use some more. You can see all the available options of this command in its help. For example, a more complete command would be user add with the main group users, an additional group sudo, use bash as a default shell environment, create a home directory, the full name average Linux user, and the username lu. Finally, you need to set a password for this new user with password wd. Type your password twice, and your new user with the password has been created. System privileges. As you have seen, I added a new user to the sudo group and granted it administrative privileges. This is what I did on my server, and this is what you would want to do if you are an admin of the system. But if you create a user on your Linux system for someone else, you probably do not want them to have administrative rights. So do not add them to the sudo group. Setting password and account expiration time. If you are a system administrator and you have many users in your system, besides not including them in the sudo group, you may also want to enhance the security of your system by the expiration time on the passwords and account of these new users. You can do this with the command change. Note, it is without n, so it is not change. You can see all the options here. You can set account expiration or define the rules for the password expiration. To check the state of the user, run change with option L and the username. As you can see, there are no expiration dates by default. I personally usually set a password expiration date to 90 days and warning about the need to update the password 30 days before the expiration. You can also set account expiration in days or provide the exact date. I will keep this account for a year. Now you see the account has some expiration settings. You can also do some manipulations with users using the command user mode. But I have to skip it because the video will be too long. How to delete a user. Finally, to delete a user, use the command user del and the username. If you also want to remove the home directory of this user, add the option R. But be careful because it will remove all the data of this user. To remind you, you can create a virtual private server at AppCloud and get $25 to your account with the promo code LU25. I showed how to set up such an AppCloud server in the video you see on your screen right now. AppCloud kindly supported this video, so I would like to thank them and thank you for watching.